Thank you, everyone. Well, like my brother, one of the first things I want to say is thank you. He named a couple people. I don't think I want to name anyone because there's so many people who came by the house and hung out with mom, ate ice cream with dad, brought us things. Just thank you. Thank you for being here as you remember my dad. Thank you for all the support that you've been over the last 4 years. We appreciate your visits and hugs. Speaking of the shared bowls of ice cream, after the service, we're going to have our reception downstairs, and we would like you all to join us, and we will be having, of course, ice cream. And we have a microphone set up down there. And so hopefully, as we've talked today, these stories kind of, if you remember little stories of dad, things that happened, we'd really love for you to share those downstairs. We're looking forward to that. So Josh talked a little bit about what it was like growing up with Claude as a dad, and you may or may not wonder what it was like to grow up as a daughter in that household with a man who was a builder and a motorcycle rider. And I did not learn the lessons. Hit throttle hard and hold on tight.
Yeah, no.
I don't know. I missed that one. But since I'm up here at the microphone, I get to choose what I want to talk about. So I am going to talk about what it was like growing up in his home. When I was little, Dad worked long hours. But when he was home, he was ours. Joshua talked about that, how he didn't go lock himself away with his hobby, but he was fully accessible to us. And I don't ever remember him sending me away saying he had work to do. He crawled on the floor with us. He played with us. He built stuff with us. He took us fishing and dirt bike riding and did other fun stuff with us. And I don't know, do you guys remember when TV only had 3 channels? Right? There was a show that my family watched all the time, The Muppet Show. Do any of you remember The Swedish Chef? Yes? So on Saturday mornings, although my dad was usually pretty quiet, if he was home on Saturday, he took over the kitchen. And I just remember him cracking eggs and saying things like, yolken, volken, eggy, broken, throwing shells around and flipping pancakes up and so close. I was wondering if they were going to stick to the ceiling. So he was truly there with us. And my dad could do anything. He built stuff. My dad built houses and fences and sheds. We had a playhouse that had a fireman's pole in it. Did you guys know? Just me? See, I told you, he could do anything. He was, the year prior to my 18th birthday, he spent hours in the garage handcrafting me book tests that I still have. But there was one thing my dad did not do. He could not stay awake past 8 p.m. watching a movie. And I think my brother inherited that trait from him as well. My dad was the strongest man I ever knew, and he could solve any problem I had. I turned to him to discuss any issues I was facing, and he could be counted on to help me think things through. And my dad was really cool. He raced motorcycles, and he flew airplanes. My dad was honest. He was a man of his word. He was gentle, and he was kind. I never saw an animal nor a child who didn't immediately love my dad. It's like he has some kind of magic over them. And I don't think it was just the food bucket. And my dad was funny. One time, my family was at Taco Bell. I think it was when we were in college and we were both home. And Josh was eating something and he's like, this is really good. You should try one sometime. We kept eating well. And Josh looked down and he's like, hey, where's my other Cholito? And my dad just looked at him and goes, you said I should try one sometime. So I did. My dad was a hard worker. He He rose early, he put in a full day's work, and he did not consider the job finished until the tools were put away and everything was cleaned up. He always checked the miles of the vehicles, he changed tires, and his tools were always in good working condition because my dad took care of things. My dad never saw the spotlight. He lived humbly and he always did his best. My dad was quiet, unless he was singing in the shower, and it was full volume with, "Oh my darling, oh my darling, oh my darling," or the one I will not try to sing, because that was bad enough. 16 times, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. My dad was patient, and my dad loved me. And a lot of what I'm saying, Josh said, know what he was going to talk about, but so we share the same truth. We'll never know. But because of Dad's warm hugs, shared grins, and the love in his eyes, I knew without any doubt that he loved me. My dad was your veteran, but he was my hero. The Bible says to store up your treasures in heaven. And now that my dad is there, it's a little dearer to my heart. And I bet most of what I said you probably already knew, and not just because Josh said it already, but because my dad was the same in public as he was in private. What you saw is the same man that we live without. And what it comes down to is this: my dad was a good man. And Micah 6:8, it reads, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. What does the Lord require of you? To act justly and love mercy and walk humbly with your God." Since I've moved here, that is the one thing that I have heard about my dad over and over. Everyone that I run into knows my dad. Oh, he's such a good man. He is such a good man. And it didn't matter if I was checking out at Walmart, and when Dad was sick and unable to come to church anymore, Mom would stay home and she'd give me her check to go get her groceries for her while I was there after church. And so when the cashiers, when I'd hand them the check and they'd see her name, some of them knew them. "How's your dad doing? How's your mom? They're such good people." And at the hardware store, anywhere, everybody would say, you know, "How's your dad doing? He's such a good." And Josh and Mom and I were tasked with the difficult job of deciding what to have inscribed on the two lines allowed on the veteran's tombstone. By the way, it's really hard to summarize somebody's life in 26 characters, 13 characters, including spaces. I hear about, what, 6 pages, and a lot of time, and we had to bring it down to 2 lines. 13 characters for life. And, you know, the headstone is pretty permanent. And so we thought about, when people are wandering through the cemetery, what do we want them to know about Dad? What do we want on there forever? What do we want them to know about this Claude H. Heber? What can we do in two lines that's going to sum up his whole life? Circling back to that. He's a good man. He's a good man. And so in the end, we chose, in our 26 characters, a good man dearly loved. And the other day, Mom, we were driving, and we were talking about how I like to keep things organized, and I plan, and I would rather have things neat. It's not always possible. I don't live in a house full of people who have that trait of meanness. And she said something about, "You're so much like your dad." And then she asked me, "Does it bother you to hear people say that you're like your dad?" No, I don't. Like my dad is exactly what I want to be. I want to be known. want to be known as a woman who's the same at home and in public, who is honest, hardworking, kind, gentle, funny, and loving. I want to be a good woman dearly loved. In Proverbs 22, it says, "A good name is more desirable than great riches. To be esteemed is better than silver or gold." And so I challenge you today, when you leave this service, to let my dad's legacy live on in you. Be honest, be kind, work hard, be humble, love well, live fully, hit the throttle hard, be a good person. And it's that every day. And I'm so thankful that I moved here. And I was able to be what he taught me to be. Not by his words, but by who he was. These last 3 years, I've had the opportunity to return some kindness and caring to him when he needed it. And I also want to say thank you to my girls and my husband for being here with us. And especially in the last few months, as my dad needed a lot of personal care, my husband stepped in a lot. We've asked Chris to come today and seek just a closer walk with me.